Oh, it's all good. Carlson kicks the leg one. Now Chiasson can't get through Krug. Long indirect pass intended for Paye. It's a billiard shot. Anderson plays it out to Carlson. It gives up possession. Campbell into the middle, but Chiasson wrecks that bid as he goes through Talbot's stick. McQuaid holds his ground on the airborne puck and knocks it to the near side. Paye leaves it for Campbell. Campbell skies it to the far corner. Mathot on the backhand gives to Carlson. He reverses. Paye jumps on that. Another turnover from Carlson. Campbell goes into the corner. Mathot one-hands it up the boards. Matt Puempel, who was a junior linemate of Ryan Spooner, brings it up the wing, fires it over Rask. Funny bounce off the end glass rolled up on the strings. Hamilton to the sideboards. Talbot just gets the puck out of the zone. And you see the difference made.
Yeah, that was CeCe on the right side, and he didn't want to go get that puck first, certainly. Allowed Lucic to chip and chase and to get the puck to establish some offensive zone time.
Mama always said it was dangerous to play on the train track. And Talbot gets tossed off the dot. Driva steers the puck to the end board, slings it around. Bartkowski takes it on the post at the blue line. Back through the corner to Paye. Talbot catches it on the backhand, snaps the pass to Bartkowski along the line to Seidenberg. Swivels it around, Paye lets it run for Talbot. Talbot holds Borowiecki standing in his own crease. Talbot waits, fires it right up the slot. Bartkowski can't keep it in the attacking zone, but turns and wrists it all the way in deep as the Bruins change out.
Yeah, it's a good game plan, though. If you don't have plays, make sure it goes back down for the point below the goal line. And to your point, Jack.
Batting a good 500. McQuaid up to Pastrnak, and the puck slides through to the neutral zone.
So is that coin I just flipped.
I'd take the coin. Much more consistent. McQuaid runs smack into a nice pick set by Kyle Raymond, the referee. Leguan turns and fires at the Dyers. Wierkosz to the hash marks, a funny deflection. And Rask shrugged the shoulders. The puck whizzed by. Leguan throws it in front. It's still loose out of Rask's glove. And McQuaid with a...
You know, and that's where you got to shorten your bench in a close game and try to get those guys on the ice in an offensive situation as best you can.
Well, what good coaches do is put players in positions to succeed. Carlson's shot kick saved by Rask, and there's Paye, but he gives it right back to Carlson on the far side. Chiasson braces for the hit against Campbell. Pretty good contact there. Dougie Hamilton to the right of his goal. Up ahead for Talbot. He can't get it out of the zone. Leguan, the quick turn to Chiasson. Chiasson's shot saved by Rask, who closed the five hole on him. Mathot off Talbot's stick, spins like a coin to Chiasson in the slot. Leguan can't pry it loose. It tumbles over to Mathot. Drives it down through the corner. Paye against Leguan at the half boards. Leguan into the slot. Rask vacates the goal to the Boston bench, and the crowd shows its disapproval of the referee's judgment. David Pastrnak, as Seidenberg left, gives it to him. He gains the line. Seidenberg hits the brakes, loses an edge. One-on-one, but he's running out of gas. They makes the change of speed move on Borowiecki. Gets help from Soderberg. He throws it off Borowiecki's legs, and the puck comes all the way back to Rask. Marchand was trying to squeeze fumes out of the tank there.
Almost pulled it off.
Took a little rest for about a third of a second.
Now, the Bruins, that line did a real good job along with the D pair.
Soderberg with a bomb striding into it, and Anderson has it stuck to his palm. No whistle for some reason, although it was in there for about 3 seconds.
Yeah, they wanted him to play it. There was no Bruin in the neighborhood. But just to finish that thought, it was Bartkowski and Seidenberg along with the Bergeron line. They kept keeping the puck below the goal line and forcing Ottawa to try and play defense. Smith came in off that left wing on a nice pass from Bergeron behind the net.
McQuaid with another huge hit on Puempel. It's the second one he's delivered tonight. McQuaid from behind the red line. Funny bounce off the quarter boards, almost squirted on goal. Bridle right through the blue paint in front of Craig Anderson. Borowiecki telegraphs the pass. Hamilton tries to hammer it deep, but couldn't get a clean swat at the puck. 2-2-1 when leading by two at any point in the game. But when you extend it to a three-goal lead, the Bruins are 12-0-1. And of course, that one was Calgary's three-goal comeback out in Western Canada.
Yeah, and it takes discipline right now here in the final minute and a half. If you have a chance in the offensive zone, only if you're 100% sure you're going to get that puck to the net. It's got to go below the goal line.
Alex Tiasson pulls up at the hash marks. David Legwan. The pass does not connect with Cody Ceci. The power move by Milan Lucic, a trademark move by him, and it was the 200th assist of his NHL career, Lucic in his eighth season. Bobby Ryan off the skates of Campbell and hits the apron of the goal. Puempel picks it up. Chara loses an edge. Puempel gives back to Zibanejad.
Entire shift in their own zone. They needed to get it out. They needed to get fresh bodies.
Patrick Wierkosz lugs it out over the middle of his own line. Chiasson gets a piece of the puck. McQuaid softly off the end boards. Puempel going to work. Gives to Chiasson around the perimeter. Porovietsky's wrist shot wide on the stick side of Rask. Grava comes in. Spooner waves at him one hand. The puck squirts all the way out to Lucic. He takes the hit from Legwan to get it center. But the Bruins unable to make a play forward to the red line. Here comes here. Quickly gets it into sixth. Tremendous guy. Campbell knocks down the attempt to clear. Legwan deflects it all the way through the neutral zone.
And that's the discipline I'm talking about right there, Jack. You know, Campbell's trying to make a play to the middle of the offensive zone. I get that. That's what you want to do. But maybe throw that puck below the goal line, especially early in this period, to force Ottawa to play in their zone and have to come 200 feet.
Ceci leaves it back of the goal. Gets the return from Puempel. North and south, and it's wide of Rask's goal. Soderberg and Legwan, neither one touches the puck, and the bodies go flying over the dot. Kelly in the mix. Krug gloves it down, steps all the way past the hash marks, throws it on Anderson. A penalty coming here. 12 and a half to go in the game. Zibanejad off the quarter boards. Puempel throws the puck back of his own goal. Carlson's probably going to play pretty much the rest of the game.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Plays 27 on average every night, and one other guy plays over 20.
Here's Peugeot all the way in. The shot wide on the stick side of Rask. Rask came all the way to the top of his crease, didn't give him much. But Peugeot is a talented player, couldn't keep it on goal. Conra's shot goes off. Conra with Ceci and Wierkosz, the defensive pair. Conra throws it into the legs of Puempel. Conra in the corner. Bergeron takes away the centering pass. Knocks down the puck. It's loose at the side of the goal. Smith knocks it to the boards. Wierkosz slaps it down to Conra in the corner off McQuaid's legs. Bounces to Peugeot against Seidenberg. He slides it back to Wierkosz. His rocket off the end boards. A score! Down with Anderson scrambling to get back in the net. Here comes Curtis Lazar. Dougie Hamilton extends the stick and poke checks the puck away. It's loose with Puempel throwing it to the post. Legwan banks the pass to Borowiecki to Kreiber. Kreiber's wrist shot. Leg saved by Rask. Hamilton one-hands it up the boards. Lucic can't get it past Legwan at the blue line. Kreiber knocks the puck cross ice. Hamilton doubled over. Borowiecki's shot saved by Rask, and Puempel keeps possession of the corner. Back to Kreiber. Settles the puck. It's off Lucic, but it dribbles through to Puempel. Off the corner boards. Krug takes it. And a tumbling muffin all the way down toward Anderson. That's going to be
Carlson, and just say, I got him, I'm going to take him. I'll give him the pass by me, but I'm going to stay right in front of him.
Seidenberg wins it away from Peugeot, but then knocks it into Puempel's skates. Carlson's one-timer with Conra jamming in the slot. Paye can't get the puck past Mathot. The big guy, Mathot, throws it to the end boards, and Boston's big guy, Adam McQuaid, wins it there. Max Talbot against Carlson turns and flips it, but Peugeot is rotating. He dribbles it down to the corner. Puempel brings it back to Carlson along the line to Wierkosz against Campbell. Wierkosz sprints to the corner, keeps it at the end of his control. Wierkosz back to Carlson, has to flatten the puck against Paye. Wierkosz all over the zone, turns, flings it into McQuaid's body. Carlson, the defenseman in the slot, slips the pass back to Peugeot, fakes the shot over to Weirkosh. Looks like a power play here, intentionally wide. Rask gets the carom off the end boards. Puempel back to Weirkosh. Here comes another one, and Campbell down on a knee to make a courageous. All in the same shift.
Yeah, and I think Riley Smith knew that it was Carlson in coverage, so he knows he can take a chance one-on-one. There's probably not going to be any body contact there. He steps right around him and just misses on the blocker side.
Paye tries to bank it in off Anderson's leg, and the puck trickles through the crease.
Tonight gave the Bruins a 3-0 lead.
This game could end up being analogous to Ottawa's season. A lousy start for the Senators, falling way behind, turning on a tremendous effort that required immense amounts of energy, and then just not having enough to finish the job at the end. You consider what the Philadelphia Flyers did with their late season push, and the Bruins smacked them down and took away a lot of their hope. Well, they lost 2-1 to Dallas tonight.